Hello students, in this session we will be understanding waterproofing system and their types. In the earlier session we understood what is waterproofing. It is to make the structure waterproof, to make the structure which is repelling the water. Thus, there is no entry of your dampness water inside the building and safeguarding your building. So, when we are talking about the types of waterproofing system, they can be classified as membrane waterproofing, crystalline waterproofing, and integral waterproofing. Let's see one by one. Membrane waterproofing. Membrane waterproofing is a thin layer of watertight material that is laid over a surface. What we do, we take a membrane, or this waterproofing system is a making use of a membrane which does not allow the water to seep into it, to the below surface. This layer is continuous and does not allow water to pass. A waterproofing membrane could be laid above the structural slab and below the finished tile. That is, your basic slab is there, above which the membrane is there, and again the second layer, the final layer of finished tiles, can be laid. This will ensure that the water does not seep to the structural slab. First the protection of tiles, and then the membrane protection, and then your basic slab. It is laid with slope so as to ensure that the draining or the flushing of water will be through the drains. That is, we don't want the water to settle at some point. We want a good flushing of the water, thus reducing the chance of water ingress. These membranes are made up of thin layers about 2 to 4 mm thickness. And they are of two types, a sheet-based waterproofing membrane and the liquid-applied waterproofing membrane. In this, the sheet-based waterproofing, but obvious, we purchase the sheet, then we paste it on the site and it is ready to use. The number of rolls, number of sheets are purchased, they are laid down, sticked, and it is ready to use. Let's see in detail. Sheet-based membranes come in the form of rolls, which needs to be unrolled and then laid on the target, a firm surface. The most common type of sheet-based membrane is a bituminous waterproofing membrane. This membrane is stuck to the roof surface by melting a tar-based adhesive on the membrane by using blowtorch. So this is what your blowtorch. One side of the bitumen membrane is what you will be seeing before, after the sticking, and the underneath part will be having a tar based adhesive which needs to be melt by using this blowtorch, and you can paste it over your firm surface, the target surface, and after which you will be sticking the number of rolls as required. The joints between the adjacent membranes are also made with the same hot adhesive, so the sticking can be done very well. The sheets are overlapped by about 100 mm thickness to form a waterproof joint. We want a waterproof joint. The joint should not be weak, else it will let the water seep into it. Membranes can be overlapped by use of hot air gun to avoid any leakages. With the bituminous membrane, we also have PVC membranes or a composite type of membrane can be used, but the bituminous is the most famous or most common. So this is what your blowtorch. This part is having an adhesive here. You can easily differentiate color of this part and color of this part. Outer surface, inner surface are in different color. This needs to be heated up and it can be adhesive, sticks the layer upon layer. So this person will be unrolling it, this unrolling of your rolls, bituminous rolls, with the help of the blowtorch, we need to stick it. This is the gas supply here. So long torch, these your layers can be obtained, and it needs to be pasted very well, else it may lead to your water seepage inside to the below surface. Now, the second type is the liquid applied waterproofing membrane. Here only buy that membrane material, make it ready, paste it with the brush or with the help of your spray machine, and that's it, it is ready to use. Let's see in detail. The liquid applied membranes are in liquid form, which are either sprayed or brush applied. Due to spraying, the liquid forms a monolithic membrane with no laps, welds or seams. In the earlier, what we had laps or we had welds, means the joining was there. Here there is no issue of joining. A complete film is there, a single film is there of your color or of that material, and that's it. So no joining, nothing, a uniform layer is there. The thickness can be controlled by varying the coats. The thickness can be controlled by varying the quantity of chemical, liquid chemical applied per unit area. The amount you are spraying can be increased, and layer upon layer can be applied, and thus you can increase the thickness. If the target surface is too large and has joints, overlapping can be done easily to avoid cold joints. In the earlier case, there may be a formation of cold joint due to some or the other reason, faulty workmanship or the lessening or availability of less adhesive on the surface, interior surface, any reason XYZ, it may lead to cold joint. But here, as it is a thin and uniform film, so there is no kind of your cold joints. As there are no joints, liquid waterproofing membranes are considered to be superior to the sheet-based waterproofing. So just you need to mix it and or take it as said in the your that brochure, and you have to spray it over the surface. Either with the spray like in this kind of machine, the spray machine, or the simple your brush. The second is the crystalline waterproofing. Here what you have to do, you have to mix that powder and use it. Due to which what happens, it forms small kind of your crystals, and those crystals are so thin enough that they grow when come into the water, and they fill up the fine cracks and every pore, and thus making it a water barrier. So let's see in detail. Crystalline waterproofing. The chemical used, the powder used, undergoes a reaction that causes long, narrow crystals to form and fill the pores. As we know that crystals are very fine, it causes a long, narrow crystals to form, which fills the pores, the capillaries and hairline cracks present in the concrete marks. It can be used for above and below grade, on the structure, water tank, manholes, etc. So it is useful for your above and below grade part of your structure. This crystalline growth continues till moisture is available. Once the concrete is cured and dried, the chemicals sit inactive in a inactive state until the other dose of water causes the chemical reaction to begin again and grows the crystals to shut off the water. What you do, you take the powder, you mix it with your chemical, all those chemicals are mixed. So when it is cured, it what happens? When it comes with your water, it will grow and fill up the cracks, and again it will be in an inactive state. But when other kind of water falls over it later, after some days or whatever, whenever the water comes into contact of it, and it forms a proper layer, the crystals grows again and fills up all the pores and the capillaries, and making it a sound quality water barrier. The water does not get any kind of access into it. No pores, no hairline cracks, nothing. The crystalline formation fills and plugs the voids in the concrete, becoming an integral and permanent part of the structure. So these are your fine crystals. We are having a pretty magnified image here. This powder is placed and you can use it. It forms, it fills up the thin, your cracks, pores, capillaries, everything. The application can be done as a coating to the target surface of an existing structure, mixed directly at the batch plant as an admixture. It can be directly mixed in the batch plant as an admixture, shaken as dry powder over fresh concrete and troweled into the surface. So it can be poured into, shaken over the fresh concrete, and it will be filling up all your pores and capillaries, or it can be mixed at the admixture as an admixture on the batch plant itself during the batching process, or a coating can be made over the surfaces for especially the existing structures. Now the third type of integral waterproofing. So it is finer and better from the earlier two. Let's see. Integral waterproofing concrete. Waterproofing concrete is done by adding the waterproofing material to the cement or the admixture. Generally, waterproofing is done by the help of spraying the liquid or applying the sheets, as we have seen in the earlier slides. Both these methods may worn out, could delaminate, damage during the backfill, decompose or deteriorate over time. But integral waterproofing uses admixtures, usually a dry powder or liquid. The admixture is added to the concrete mix at the batch plant or at the job site. Wherever the batching is done, it is added as an admixture. Means the quantity required is very less. Some forms of integral waterproofing may have self-heal, minor cracking, making it more user-friendly and beneficial to user. What happens? Some form of integral waterproofing may have a self-fill and minor crack healing properties. So what happened? It makes it more user-friendly and beneficial. And the using is very simple. You don't have to purchase a sheet, bring it on the side, heat it, apply an adhesive, or adhesive needs to be melted and pasting has to be done, overlapping has to be done properly. No, the bitumen, not like the bituminous, or not like the liquid membrane, bring it, purchase it, keep the safety, spray it, do the maintenance. It is nothing like that. You just have to, what here in this integral, take the, assuming it like to be some kind of admixture, add it at the batch plant, mix it in the concrete, and it is ready to use. So it could be used during your batching itself, or it can be powder shaken on the surface. Benefits: as the admixture is added at the batching plant itself, the complete concrete mass is made waterproof. Lowers the maintenance cost, simple to use, just mix it and leave it. Low time usage, useful when exposed to severe chemicals, useful when sheet proofing can't be used, and no defects in waterproofing process, especially the defective workmanship is overcome. Thin and inadequate membrane layers are the issues related to thin or inadequate membranes are overcome, and no formation of hole joints. Just mix it in the concrete and it is ready to use. A complete waterproofing and complete waterproof of all the concrete is achieved. So what we learned, we understood the types of waterproofing system, like the membrane waterproofing, crystalline waterproofing, and integral waterproofing. Well, that's it for now. Thank you.